Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute, y'all. Counting like a cherry pony. Counting like a cherry pony. Your boy done switched up on you. Counting like a cherry pony. Counting like a cherry pony. You are lying to me. Pony. And I know you lying. Counting like a cherry pony. Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute, y'all. You guys, look. If this is your very first time to this channel, run on and subscribe for us. And after you subscribe, make sure you hit that notification bell beside the word subscribe so that you'll be notified each and every time that we upload a video. And then, welcome to this great family. Now that you're a part of us, there are some things that we do. And we do them every day because they help us grow. Those things are comment, comment, coming like a share ain't go, team. Coming like a share and go.
Hey,
my team.
Hey,
coming like a share and don't forget to come in like a share.
Hey,
coming like a share. Coming like a share. Don't forget to come in like
what?
A share.
What?
Coming like a share. Coming like a share. Don't forget to. Don't forget to come in like a share. Okay, hey. Guys, check this out. We're going to pray. We'll get into the goodness. Here we go. Amen. How y'all doing today? How y'all doing today? How y'all doing today? I guess you guys can see today. Hubby is joining us. Today, it's going to be Friday when you get this video, but we're doing Therapy Thursday.
On Friday.
Okay, you guys, for the food, we have got some lasagna. We got some fried okra, fried chicken. We got some corn, some jalapenos, and we have got some garlic bread. And guess what? Over to the side. The bean is in the building, y'all. There you go, there you go, there you go. The bean is in the building, y'all. There you go, there you go, there you go. Let me see if you're nice and refreshed. Yes, he is. You guys, Lil Ben has Diet Dr. Pepper him today. Also, get to the side, I got my lips hot sauce. If you like your bottle, wear the top screw spots in blue, hit that link and right there you get your lips hot sauce. You guys, I've also got some crushed red peppers over here. We've got some pepper. We have got some Parmesan cheese. And I have got some peppers from Church's Chicken, because that's where this bird came from. You hear me? Mm-hmm. Okay, y'all, let's get to eating. Let's get to eating.
Stop
with my bird. Okay. Fried okra.
Grand Wild from Jack and Church.
I'm enjoying it. Y'all want the juice off of the peppers for my chicken and ooh. Oh, yes. Let me get your bacon. For the Church's fried chicken. Put me some hot sauce on there, honey. I'm gonna give people the hot sauce on. Oh, it's smoking.
They hit
fresh, of course. Fresh, fresh, fresh.
Exactly.
You guys back home in Memphis, we had, for one, the Memphis Church Fried Chicken got everywhere.
Everywhere.
Popeye just kind of a scarcely around.
Every once in a while, you might pop into one.
There are some there.
You know, you got right around. You might see one.
But the dominant chicken place says in Memphis are KFC and Church's. Those are the dominant chicken places.
It's not the same down here.
Mm-mm.
At least not where we at.
Well, the chicken is.
The chicken is, what? No, well, chicken, well, it depends on where you go to, so the time of that. But this is pretty good chicken. But you ain't gonna run to them right out here.
They're just not everywhere like they are in Memphis.
What you said.
And baby, we run the churches on Sunday. And Tuesday, Wednesday, I forgot which day it was. Oh, but one of them days, you get a piece of the buried honey for $5. Yes, you could. Woo! Y'all piece of corn? There you go. Oh, that's good. It's sleeping all out of my mind.
Try that.
You guys, the lasagna, we bought it. This is a Stouffer's lasagna. Oh, a Stouffer's lasagna here. Get into it. Get into it. Oh, right.
Wait a minute, guys.
It's good. It takes forever to cook, but it's good. Yeah, this is good. This is good. You guys, we actually got, we're gonna go ahead and get started because we actually got two topics.
Today.
That are current news.
Well,
but not so current news. And we didn't talk about this when either of them broke, because when things first happened, and you make videos and do commentary about them, in the beginning, especially before it has time to kind of level out,
do what you gotta do.
You can choose a side. And your opinion can be swayed before you have all the facts. Or all the facts is going to come out anyway. So our first topic is going to be, which one are we going to do first?
Kirk
Franklin.
Uh-huh.
Kirk Franklin is in the news, or has been in the news, still in the news, been in the blogs, been everywhere, honey.
Everybody got something to say about that.
Everybody got something to say about him cursing out his oldest son. Whatever went on, went on. They got into it on the phone.
I'm getting a little bit. I'm talking about a little bit.
Y'all, I love the peppers from church. I like the whole pepper, even. However it was, y'all, they got into it over the phone, and the son decided to record the conversation. Okay?
You know you're on the right channel, baby. You know you're on the right channel.
So, anyhow, Kirk Franklin done a lot of cussing. A little threatening. Basically told his son that he would break his neck for disrespecting him. Now that's what he said. He said what he said.
Stood by.
Stood by what he said. They've been on Tamron Hall. They've been many places across the tube since this has happened. Obviously, you know, Kirk Franklin is a huge gospel entertainer, advocate for, you know, gospel of the Christian faith. So this has caused quite a ripple in the world of Christianity. Now, this is what I'm going to say about it first.
Go ahead, tell me your opinion. Because that one I want to know. I got some insight.
Whatever I have to do to reach my child, I don't care what it is, I'm going to do. And I keep thinking, everybody keeps saying, well, that's a grown man, it's a grown man, it's a grown man. That's still his child.
When you finish with it.
That's how I feel about it. I feel like that whatever you have to do to reach your child and whatever kind of way that you need to reach them, that's what you got to do. Because especially in the Christian faith, just for the simple fact of the matter that you want your child, you know, to go on, be saved, you know, live a decent life, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
And being dishonorable or, yes, dishonorable to your mother or your father is one of the biggest.
Yeah.
It's one of the Ten Commandments. Honor thy mother and father. So, I don't think Kirk done anything wrong. What you think?
Personally, if he's doing it now, it ain't nothing new. It ain't nothing new. If, if he's heavy-handed with his son, he's heavy-handed with his son. Now, you live to be 30-something years old. However old he is right now, right?
In his 30s.
Right, you live to be 30-something years old, however old you are right now. This ain't the first time he done went off on you. It's the first time you decided to report it. You did get just to hurt that man. And you shouldn't have done that. I mean, outright, I think the son was absolutely wrong for sitting back there and posting what's going on behind their closed doors. I don't... Kirk Franken, I believe him. I believe in him. I believe in his...
I ain't gonna see it. I ain't gonna see it.
I believe in I believe in his message. I respect his practice, you know what I'm saying? And I still, to this second, don't listen to his music, no matter what. Whatever the heck they're doing, whatever the heck's going on behind closed doors does not change anything, my opinion about him.
His stature.
At all. You know
I don't think so either. And when this first happened, y'all, me and hubby had a discussion. He swore that the child was going to hurt Kurt's career.
It could.
I told him,
It could have, no, but that's the reason why he put it out. He put it out
there. That may be, yeah, that was the reason.
The reason why he did better near.
But he wasn't going to hurt Kurt Franken, honey. He was not going to hurt him. He wasn't. He wasn't going to hurt him because, my lasagna step on my fault, please. If it don't, man, maybe I should go and put it in my mouth. Right.
Put it in your mouth.
Do it now.
No, but do it back on track. That man sit back on you. Try how you going? You went for that man's career. You went for his pockets. That what he was trying to do. You trying to sit back on diminish his reputation in the eyes public, in the public eye.
Public eye.
Right. And you wrong for it because when you were coming up, when he fed you off of all that, now he still was heavy handed then. He's not gonna change it because he got older. I ain't gonna say whatever.
All I gotta say is don't. You know that's Kirk Franken, you know what I'm saying?
I understand though, so what? But why wait 15, 20 years at me, you know what I'm saying? You get 30 years old, now all of a sudden you want to grow some. Now you want to grow up here. Now all of a sudden he wrong.
Well, according to what Kirk mm-hmm. said to him and his wife, he's always been in trouble for them. Because Kirk's marriage to his wife, that is not this particular son's mother.
Right.
So my understanding, he's always been problems. I don't think so because he wouldn't have been saying stuff on there like he just want to lay around and rub on his wife's booty. That kind of stuff. Nobody would say that about their mom.
But the thing of it is that's his life.
Well, I don't guess because he said all this about his daddy.
Yeah, but I'm like, that's his wife. That's his life. That's his daddy's life. So why are you going to sit back? I'm just saying.
He was saying that's all Kirk got time for. With his wife,
and his music.
His other children, and his music. And saying that he see all the time that Kurt is acknowledging him as his son, but he don't basically do anything for him. He's not there with him. He doesn't really communicate with him well. That type of thing. Mm-hmm.
Oh, but if you don't expect about all this stuff you're saying, watch me say his part of the conversation. Watch him record and play his part of the conversation.
Well, he did. He did. Right. He played his part.
When he snapped back, I know that Kirk didn't just call that man up yelling at him for no reason.
Mm-mm. But he played it. He didn't play the initial part of it
right.
to show the reason why Kirk was going
right.
on. But everything that he was saying to Kirk, we did hear that.
That man sit back there. He sit back there, ignited. He said the cause, ignited the situation. Can't calm down.
Recorded. Well, we don't know that. Allegedly.
It looks like a setup to me.
That's it does, but allegedly now.
You set that mind up. You don't sit back and do that to your dad.
Because I can't fight Kirk. I can't fight Kirk or his son. Allegedly. No, I ain't got time to go to court with none of them. Allegedly.
Allegedly. To me, it looks like a setup. It's just outright, it's just, you don't do that. I mean, seriously.
So, basically, what you saying that he provoked it in order to get clout.
He provoked the situation, had everything ready, set the stuff up, he caught it in the midnight. You talked in the midst of it. I mean, I heard him speaking back in the middle of it, but I'm like, he just, man.
It was a setup.
He just set up. He just, I don't think you hear his truck running going off. And I'm like, that's the first thing. Nigga. I'm like, okay.
Now, you know what I'm saying? Just, the state of the war that is heightening the situation is not just to Kurt without his son. Kurt Franklin had a few choice words to say.
Okay.
He said the N word.
Okay.
He said quite a few curse words. I listened to it.
Alright.
Undoctored, unmuted, and everything. I listened to it all. And I say, go ahead, Kurt. That's what I say. Lil Lip get 30 years old, thinking she gonna disrespect me?
That man,
Kirk Franklin
came that man like a grown man. He
from
the
business.
You stepped out that way. You know what I'm saying?
Like I told y'all before, right. My mother, God bless her soul, mm-hmm. I was 28 years old, almost 30, and spoke out of turn and she, pow, slapped me.
Yeah.
Slapped me silly, you hear me? I was 28 years old. So, you know, I say go, Kurt. You know.
I ain't mad.
And then he was telling his son, you're not going to disrespect me. And the son was like, I did it. And I honestly believe, they tell me the way Kurt cussed him out. I honestly believe if Kurt had been there where he was, he'll have shouted at me. I'm trying to choke him for real. I'm giving y'all another piece of this bird, honey.
They called the ambulance. I'm sitting in that mine back home. I'm just in this mine back home. Okay. I'm telling you right now.
He on his way. That was an awful thing. But there's another conversation we're going to talk about real quick. And then we're going to combine them at the end because people are using these two incidences to try to indirectly attack the Christian faith, okay? Basically saying this person done this, this person done that. How can you be a man of God? How can you, you know, whoop, this, that, and a third, mm-hmm. Okay? Now, the second instance that we're going to talk about, y'all, that uncle got good to me right now. The second instance that we're going to talk about, you guys, is everything that has been going on all over YouTube, the blogs, and everything else again, about Donnie McClurkin. Okay? People are trying to say, which most of us that follow, what is the book? Which is in the video, which one?
I'm thinking, let me finish a minute. She bored.
Most people, you know, that follow things, try to keep up on things, everything a little bit nosy. You know, mm-hmm. You know, a little bit nosy.
Don't do that.
Don't
do that. Don't do that.
Know that.
Don't come funny, bro.
In the past, Donnie McClurkin has lived a life of homosexuality. Everybody knows that. He says that God delivered him from it. He testified to it, came out with it, went on. Living a lovely life, pastor, you know, run Sunday best, or has ran Sunday best. A lot of work in the community, for the Christian community, for sure. The black community as well, you know. Powerhouse in a lot of different areas.
Right.
Donnie McClurkin. Donnie McClurkin.
Right. That guy.
Made a video, I guess an interview.
Guess you're going to be on VH1 or something.
Like a series or something.
Like if he had a documentary or something that's coming out, that was probably coming, he's going to be on whatever, something on Sunday.
Okay, well, however it is that it happened.
On Sundays. I don't know.
He said that he believes that he would be alone as far as a mate goes for the rest of his life. Let me tell you why. He said in his past, he has a mixture of both men and women. God delivered him from homosexuality. So he's not with men. And he's saying that he doesn't get a woman. He just don't know what she wants. He doesn't know what to do as far as, I don't know if it's so much as please her sexually, but he just don't get her, basically, a female, a woman.
He's saying he doesn't know how to deal with the situation.
Right.
When struggles, like you're in a relationship and certain struggles or certain things come up, instead of dealing with it with a woman, he'll just shirk back, kind of shrug it off, go back to his music.
And go, no, actually what he said was, go back to my safe place. That's the thing that's getting everybody riled up. He said, I'm going to go back to my safe place, which he explains that his safe place is his music, his ministry. But people done took, I cannot let him get away with that.
But that's...
People are trying to say that when he said, I'm going back to my safe place, that he's going back to men. That man is city. He didn't say that.
Why does it have to be the first thing to go into your mind? Why, I mean, it's people, not you,
but yeah, people, some of you.
Some of you.
I'm called like it is.
Why would y'all sit back there and do that? I mean, that man's a man's like everywhere else. You know what I'm saying? He said he was there. He said he'd been delivered. He said whatever the heck is going on. This is his problem right now. You can't blame that man for his past.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You can't sit back there and judge somebody for what they have done or what jail you came from, what sexual orientation that you were or whatever. Mm-hmm. You judge them on who you are, the fruits of their labors now, who he is right now as a man and what he's going for in his future. You cannot sit back here and do that man that way. And don't sit back here and play. And if it was a good, being whoever you are is not a bad thing. I'm just saying, in general, if that was his choice and that's what he wanted to do, don't put it up. You know what I'm saying?
Whoop-dee-doo.
What is that about to do? What does that change his ministry? How does that sit back there and change? The man sit back there and did. We fall down. We get up. How does that change the way that
wait!
Said we fall down, but we got up. Ain't that how it went?
Wait!
Don't do that.
I'm trying to see where you was in the middle of a conversation. You just broke out with that. Is kind of what happened?
You missed the whole. I said, how did. You know what? Never mind.
My
dad. I was like, you were chewing.
You was on the wrong too, huh?
You were chewing. I'm like, but they,
lovely at that.
How did they sit back here and go, that doesn't change the impact that song had on me. You know what I'm saying? Because of
anything. Are you talking about his song?
Yeah, what he does with his ministry, what he has put out there, the way that his music affects me, is not going to change because something he did in his past or how he's feeling right now is something different. The music is going to still be the music. The message is still going to be the message.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Him changing, him being whoever the heck he is or changing his mind about whoever, saying, well, I think I'm Asian and I'm going to go over. It doesn't change the fact that he's made some outstanding music. You know what I'm saying?
And you know what I'm talking about too? Even if he did revert to whatever he's going to revert to or whatever he wants to do, that's that man lying. The God... look, first and foremost, God said that no one sin is any bigger than the other. It ain't. So, the preachers in the pulpit that are heterosexual, they sin too?
Mm-hmm.
What is the difference? God can anoint and use a turtle to bring people to the kingdom of heaven. And then also, what I can't understand is why they're trying to loot two individual men and say, or to attack Christianity.
Yeah,
because the thing of it, in general, the thing of it is this is what, this is how I truly feel about it all together. Both of the situations. God ain't gonna be no less of a God, no matter what Kirk Frank can do.
Exactly.
God ain't gonna be no less of a God, no matter what Donnie McClurkin can do.
Y'all spend more time focusing on y'all own sins and then sins of somebody else, then maybe it'll bring us to a better situation. Don't be worried about what he done, how he gonna do it, what's going on with him. Sit back and internalize that. So, I mean, you're lashing out at somebody else because of some stuff that you probably already done anyway. You feel some wrong inside yourself, you're gonna put it off on somebody else so you can feel better. That's how I think about it. I mean, that's why I think, and then all y'all get together, band together, and all of a sudden, it's Christian's fault. I was saying it's the Christian church. Mm-hmm. Now it's the Christian faith.
The black Christian church.
But you see, I just don't sit back. I don't understand. I'm focusing on me. I'm going to try to be a better me today. And that's all I can do.
And when it comes to Donnie McClurkin, everybody's saying, oh, you know, he was lame. God didn't deliver him. God this, God that. God didn't deliver him from that. So not only are you attacking the man, now you're attacking that God cannot deliver him from homosexuality? Wait. Mm-hmm. So, you are attacking him as a man because of Christianity. Right. But then you turn around and you attack Christianity by saying, what God can't do. Man, get out of here. I cannot listen to you no more. I can't listen to you. Mm-hmm. How you going to attack the man on behalf of Christianity? Being unwillingly or unknowingly attack Christianity, saying that God did not, you know, that God couldn't have saved him or delivered him from homosexuality. I can't listen to you no more.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm. Kind of man, I sit back here and say, look, hey, I don't get it. But he, I don't know. Too much. Why'd you over? Well, go ahead.
Don't worry about it.
Go ahead. I ain't gonna get all that.
Don't worry about it.
This is my leftovers.
Y'all let us know what y'all think about these two conversations in the comments. Like I said, we're a little late because I didn't want to speak on it when it first came out. I wouldn't have had all the facts.
But once you sit there and you get the facts and you kind of let it sim a little bit, we kind of, you know, you want to get our mind together right before we sit back and come see with anything. You know?
Well.
Just kind of sort.
Sometimes when things come out on social media, especially when it's in your lane. Like I said before, all the facts come out and everything. You don't want to be caught saying too much of nothing. Because, you know, people, you know, some things, like I said, especially when you are in the same lane, people tend to think that you are picking at stuff or, you know, trying to spin a narrative. So that's the reason why we didn't say anything about the Donnie McClurkin thing for sure. And the Kirk Franklin thing, anything that deals with and touches, you know, Christian faith, you got to sit back. Let that thing sim out some, you know what I mean? Let that thing do what it's going to do and then come back before you give me an opinion, because you can take what you think that people are saying and doing the wrong way. And that really don't be what they're doing or saying. So you have to let that thing sim out some and then come bike. You know, so when it first came out, we were like, Hulu, not yet. Hulu, not yet. You know what I'm saying? Before we can come back and kind of talk about it and make sure that we say allegedly. Because we don't know any of these people or what went on. Now, we heard what they both said. We heard what Kirk said, and we heard what Donnie McClurkin said. But we don't know them to know what angle they were going for what it is that they did say. We know Kirk was trying to get his son together. He was trying to gather him. Gather him. You know, he was trying to gather him so he didn't know that. But anyway, y'all, we're going to get up out of here. We love you guys so much, and we hope that you guys have enjoyed Therapy Thursday. Oh, on a Friday. We're going to see y'all next time. And we hope that you guys have enjoyed. We hope that you have enjoyed. Don't worry about it. To all our new legion, thank you guys so much for being here. We truly, truly appreciate each and every one of you. Each and every one of you special to us. Truly you are. You could have chosen to be with us in the world, but you chose to be with us. And we love you for it. Mwah. To all existing DJ.
Run around me, go.
To
run around me, go.
Uh-uh.
Run around me.
Hulu.
You did? Yo, Hulu. Don't do that.
Not yet. Not yet.
What?
Round like this in Legion. Hey! Round and round we go. Hey! Round and round we go. Hey! We love you guys so much. And we're going to see you guys next time. Wait a minute, y'all. You guys look. Always remember that there's always more than one way home. All you have to do is get there. So get there, people. Get there. We love you all. And we're going to see you guys next time. And if you're not going to watch us next time, you have lied to me. And I know you lied. Period. Bye, bye. Mwah. Woo.
That's a lot.
That was weird.
That's a lot.
Well, a lot.
That's a lot.
Man, you just fit his whole plate in the bed with me, huh?
That's a lot.
Now let me get in it.
You good, though.
Bust y'all.
You good, though.
Anyway, y'all. And y'all can see I wasn't fooling. I just kept talking, running my mouth.
Let's slow down, right?
And, bye-bye. Look out.